Greetings to everyone. We continue on here. Ultimately, we do get it like that. We do simply make a choice, and we see the vision. We see that we need the continuity problem. We see the remedy of the continuity problem, and we apply it like that, ultimately. But the chances of anybody getting there to making that choice without being a workaholic on this issue, the continuity issue, are slim and none. Slim and none. So the utility, the usefulness of these videos is to, one, help you continue your workaholic attitude, your work ethic, which is all important. Don't put anything before that. You have to be a workaholic. Two, it gets you familiar with that the continuity problem is the only problem there is, the only issue there is. Three, it gets you used to what's useless and what's useful in resolving the continuity problem. And so it's working on those levels. It's working on right use of time, right use of mind, and familiarity, and all of those. So actually, as you spend time on this, you're compiling a tremendous amount of momentum. Tremendous. Even though you can't quite fit it together, how many actually realize they don't need to fit anything together? See, which is the ultimate realization. Like that, you can eventually. I'm getting very close to that, but how close is very close? I don't know, right? There can be a lot of moments of very closeness. So, but these videos are helpful. Otherwise, I wouldn't be doing them. And it's just simply, you have to continue your workaholic. If you're not a workaholic on the spiritual path, your chances are slim and none to success. I know there are people who said, one day I just kind of woke up and it seemed like the eye dissolved and that was it. And well, okay, maybe that they were working on it, workaholic at some level or something, or maybe it was the ego's notion of dissolving the ego. The ego's notion of dissolving the ego. See, we don't realize that the ego has been our guide for a long, long time, for eons, and our guide to trying to the contingency issue. Remember, the real issue is not contingency, but continuity. The ego works on trying to solve the contingency problem. The Holy Spirit works on solving the continuity problem. So CNC. Ego is contingency. Holy Spirit is continuity. The contingency problem cannot be solved. It's completely futile. The continuity problem can be solved. Absolutely can be solved. So the ego has been advising us on how to solve the contingency problem of what if reality were annihilated. And it's trying to guide us to a solution for this. And there is no solution. If reality were to be annihilated, we'd be annihilated. There's nothing would survive it. So it's just a waste of time. But we're so used to listening to the ego. What we really do with the ego is we have the ego look for us. So even if we talk about the Holy Spirit and how it solves the contingency continuity problem, the Holy Spirit solves the continuity problem, we'll send the ego out to look at it and then report back to us. So the ego is like our eyes and our ears, and it comes back and says, this is what it is. And we take its word for it. And the ego is a complete liar and a complete deceiver and a complete knucklehead that has no clue of what it's really looking at. What the ego wants us to do is it wants us to mix fantasies together. Okay, a fantasy of light and a fantasy of darkness. Mix those two together as what? A temporary compromise in exchange for the real solution to the continuity problem, which would be like a pure fantasy that reminds us of reality, the fantasy of no need for any death, the death-free realm. That's a fantasy too. All form is fantasy. All form. God doesn't know form at all. Has no knowledge of form whatsoever. All form is simply a fantasy. But the way to be reminded of the formless reality is to see a form that is perfectly problem-free, perfectly free of any threat, not trying to change what it is, perfectly death-free and beautiful and immaculate. And to see that reminds us of reality. Also, in this world, we can choose to see the no-thingness, as it were, and to see all is one. See, everything is just one seamless, holy whole. As it were, seeing God everywhere, as it were. Seeing the reminder of God, reflection everywhere. There's like only everywhereness, seeing that vision. Those solve the continuity problem. So the ego is not working on the continuity problem at all. But it, when you ask for the ego for help, it just thinks that you're confused and you want help on the contingency problem. So it'll go out and look whatever you want to say and come back and tell you whatever is it sees as helpful to work on the contingency problem. So the Holy Spirit doesn't work on the contingency problem, only the continuity. The ego doesn't work on the continuity problem, only works on the contingency issue. That's it. That is it. So it, what guide we choose is up to us. We can choose one or the other. But choose very carefully and wisely. So it's possible that the ego will come back to someone and tell them, oh yeah, here's the answer to whatever your problem is that you're asking for, and then lays out some kind of pseudo-enlightenment or something like that. That is very possible. There are those who say that they have this I has dissolved. Now, the ego is obsessed with I. Holy Spirit's not obsessed with I. It's not even important to talk about who I am, what is this I, what is the self. That's all nonsense. That's the ego. That's ego talk. The Holy Spirit's only interested in solving the continuity problem, which is this vision, the vision of Christ, change perception. And you could say that in that change perception, there is no I-ness. What is I? The ego, the I is simply working on the contingency problem. It's some presumed something that is supposedly wants, it's that which supposedly wants the contingency problem to be solved, and is working on it, but there isn't anything there at all. But it's process. The I, when you refer to the I, it really means process instead of presence. So when the vision of Christ is the vision of presence, there's no process there. You're not viewing process at all. So you might say you're not viewing any I. But I is just shorthand for process, actually. And so you have this issue, and it's, I see some that said they're enlightened. I go online and I look at YouTube, etc., and they say, yeah, I woke up enlightened, and then so many like this, and then they're still. I'm not getting it. And I shake my head and say, wow, why am I not getting it? It just doesn't seem like they're actually seeing this vision of no process. Because when you do, from the models that I have seen seeing it, you're like Ramana or Anandamayima or someone like that. You are like them. I mean, you are seeing it. You are seeing the no-I-ness, in other words, the devoid of process. And you're seeing immaculate beauty every moment. And you're in bliss, and you are. I'm not getting that from all these people who said that they have woken up and are enlightened and all this stuff. I'm getting a bunch of mental stuff. So what's going on? What is going on? It's possible that the ego delivers this message of enlightenment to them, and they accept what the ego tells them. That's very possible. And say, don't worry, you're enlightened now. And they say, okay. And the ego says, it'll take care of the rest. And so they say, yeah, I'm enlightened, and talk about enlightenment, etc. But no, enlightenment is something altogether different than that. It's the vision. It's just a blissful vision that is just absolutely lights you up, as it were, with this gratitude and freedom and realization that you're free of suffering forever, and you become just unbelievably expansive in your compassion and love and kindness and wisdom, and everything is just amazing. Those are the role models that I hold as a standard, that you that is what the vision brings. So I this all stuff, oof, waste of time to even talk about it, because it's really, the I-ness is not just body here. It's all form. Everything we see in the universe is I-ness. It is process. is the presumption that out of this process will come some new identity, a new identity for us. So the I might stand for the process towards a new identity, really. So you're looking at everything and you see it as process towards something. But that's an illusion. There is actually no process that's taking place at all. Each moment is fresh and clean from every other moment. But we are presuming it's all linked towards some new identity, which we call the I. No one's ever seen the I. It's not anywhere. But it's not, again, not just this human body. Everything has an, like, quote-unquote, I nature, as it were. It's a process. You see a plant, it's a process. You see even the dirt, it's a process. It's being fragmented down and then buried and compacted. And there's nothing that's not a process going on here, or at least has the illusion of process here constantly. This is all hypothetical, so it's like a dream of process, as it were. Yeah, I mean, it is a dream of process. But we don't have to see it that way. We don't have to see it that way. We can see it as a dream of no process also. And that reminds us of reality, whereas the dream of process doesn't remind us of reality at all. So it's useless to solve the continuity issue. Useless. Absolutely useless. Doesn't matter what we do. Doesn't matter what we do. Seeing process is completely useless. It doesn't help. Doesn't help. Doesn't solve this continuity problem. The ego is aware that we have this problem, and it's trying to help us, but it thinks it's a problem with contingency, that we're mislabeling it and we don't understand. It thinks the solution is to find a new identity. No, the Holy Spirit knows the solution is to remember our true identity, to be reminded accurately of reality, the wholeness, reminded of wholeness. Our reality, our identity is wholeness. We don't have some separate identity. Our identity is wholeness. We have to be reminded of wholeness. There's no process in reality. There's nothing being completed. It's whole, always whole. What it always is, entirely what it is. It's not waiting for something to be added to it. No. That's the contingency plan. What if reality were annihilated? How could we survive that? That's what contingency plan is working on. We don't need the contingency plan because reality will never be annihilated. It can't be changed in any way. We don't need it. Totally unnecessary. So it is helpful to put it in this terminology that I'm putting it. I'm reframing the situation. I'm not using classical Advaitin or Neo-Advaitin or any of that kind of framework. It needs to be reframed because too many situations I've seen where people say there so many people are enlightened, and people start to say, well, okay, this is what enlightenment is, and I just say, no, it's not. It is not. It is absolutely not. Enlightenment is way more profound than what's being portrayed. And yet it's very, very doable. Very, very doable. Very doable. And again, it can, like that, okay. Ultimately, after you've worked a lifetime to differentiate between what is useful and what is useless, then at some point you will just say, ah, I see it so clearly, it's not a problem. After a lifetime of work, or if you've worked on previous lifetimes, that will be carried over. Everything that we've done in our life gets carried over to the next life. Everything. I know that for a fact because I know what my previous life was to this, and there's some other, many other stretching back, but the previous one, there was some commentary on it. And I was able to research the commentary on it. And I was able to determine that all the attributes that I had in this life were exactly the same. Exactly. And I knew for sure you carry everything over. Everything is carried with you. So the work you do now, if you shouldn't make it this lifetime, will be carried over. Absolutely will be carried. And some carry this over and they come into the world and then they do. They just get it like that. But it's not helpful to think that everybody can do it that way. It should be very, very much pointed out that's from previous efforts. Otherwise, people will get misled. The ego will say, you don't need to work hard on it. Look at that. They did it just like that. This is a piece of cake. You know, and of course, the ego is talking about the contingency plan and getting you to keep working on that, which is not a piece of cake. It wants you to spend all your time on that because it's so difficult. It's not difficult. It's actually impossible. It's actually impossible. So, oh well, trying to adjust the lighting, but it's not doing it. Maybe I can do it a little bit here. Everything's a little buggy with technology, very buggy, but we're still using it in an intelligent way here, which is super important. We're using it to help resolve the continuity problem, right? Instead of the contingency issue, which cannot be resolved. There's no resolution to the contingency issue. None. Zero. Nada. It's a waste of time. A total waste of time. And most people waste their time on that, unfortunately. Their entire lives are wasted on the struggling with the contingency problem. Never get it. Never. And it just, whatever time you spend on the contingency problem is wasted time. Totally wasted time. The only benefit you get out of it is to recognize that it was wasted time. Say, I wasted all that time. Say, okay, good. It's good to see that. It's good to see it. And now I know I'm not going to continue wasting time in that way. So that's how you use it. You know, the way you overcome regret is to stop wasting time. Time can be used to work on the continuity issue or the contingency issue. Either way, it's up to you. So time can be used either way. And just don't try to use it. Don't think you can use it both equally and that's the answer. That's the ego coming up with a compromise as a temporary distraction. Again, you need a pure fantasy, not some crazy mixture of death and life. That doesn't remind you of reality at all. We might say this world here is a crazy mixture, isn't it? Of death and life, as it were. There's no reminder there. That is utterly confusing and confounding and bizarre and whimsical and eccentric, etc., etc., etc. It doesn't remind us of reality in the slightest bit. And yet the ego saying, "Oh yeah, that's very helpful." Well, it reminds us of the contingency issue, which is what the ego wants us to keep working. Oh, what if life could be destroyed? What if reality could be destroyed? Of course, you have life and it dies. You think, "Oh my gosh, life can be destroyed. We got to come up with a contingency issue. So we need to keep perpetuating life here and reproducing here and keep life going until we figure out a way to survive death, the death of life, etc." That's the contingency issue. Don't need to work on that at all. It's totally unnecessary, both futile and completely unnecessary. So we overlearn because it's necessary, because the ego is such a problem for us. We the ego tells us that the continuity issue is simple. Just keep listening to the ego, because that's what you're used to. It says, "See, no problem." But you're not working on the continuity issue when you listen to the ego. You're working on the contingency issue. So nothing's being resolved at all. Nothing. Nothing. Now, there are some people who on their deathbed give up process, give up trying to bring anything to some sort of completion, trying to complete anything. They say, I can't work on anything anymore. And their mind relaxes and they get a glimpse. They get a glimpse of the one, the oneness, vision of oneness. And they think they're enlightened then. And say, okay, and people then, the ego tells them, "Oh, don't worry, you can work on contingency your entire life, and when you die, you'll be enlightened." Look at the, they're not enlightened. They get a glimpse of it. That's all. At death, if you haven't, when you die, you can get a glimpse of it, but that's it. All the rest of the stuff of familiarity with the ego carries on with you. If you spend a lifetime of relying on the ego as your guide, you haven't solved the continuity problem at all. It doesn't matter if you get a glimpse. It doesn't solve the continuity problem, because you're still going to be listening. The ego will tell you, "Hey, you can't switch over to the Holy Spirit. That's a continuity problem." You say, "Oh no, that's right. I'm frightened to do that. I'm going to stick with you, ego." So the ego then will just loop your experience that you had, just enfold it back into working on the contingency issue. That's all that it does. It's not enlightenment. Just because you woke up for a moment doesn't mean you're enlightened. It's the continuity issue is the only issue there is. It's really, enlightenment is not the issue, actually. It's not at all. It's solving the continuity problem. That's the issue. Forget about enlightenment. Forget about the I, the self, the ego, everything. Just forget. That's all beside the point, really. it's only in the context of solving the continuity issue does any of that make any have any relevance whatsoever. Otherwise, it's useless to even talk about any of that stuff. It's the ego that asks, "Who am I?" The ego wants to know, "Who am I? You know, where's the I? Where's the I? You know, where's the completion? Where can I find completion?" That's delusion. Where can I find completion within this hypothetical? What process? Where's the process that leads to completion? No. The continuity issue is solved when you realize you don't need any completion here in hypothetical land. You don't need any completion. You don't need any process. Because reality doesn't need any completion. The whole issue of completion is the opposite of reality. Reality isn't waiting to be completed. So that's all useless. Useless. Just like finishing the spiritual path is useless. You know, no one ever finishes the spiritual path. They realize they don't need to finish the spiritual path. Nothing needs to finish. Nothing needs to take even another one more step towards anything. There are no steps that need to be taken at all, which is why you can see everything as it is, this very instant, this holy instant, the holy instant. The holy instant, and that instant, it can be your vision continuously. Nothing taking any step at all. Not a step forward, not a step backward, no steps at all. Just a total presence right now. That will go a long ways to solving the continuity problem. I see it as a sort of an intermediate step to dwelling in the death-free realms, and that is a absolute certain solution to the continuity problem. But as we're here in this world, we need to at least acknowledge that what's the utmost we can do in this world to solve the continuity problem, and that is this vision of the holy instant. Absolutely, that is it. And you see it, you say, this reminds me of something. It's just like what? Just like reality. Yeah, it's very similar reality. So then the world becomes useful. Whereas right now, the perception of process, the world is useless to everyone. Totally useless. And yet we don't need to throw it away because we can use it for something. It's like somebody has a boat and they have it full of water, and you say, "What are you doing?" They say, "Well, I need something to..." They say, "There's someone there, there's a boat full of water, and they need to get across the river." And they say, "I can't get across." And I say, "Well, why don't you use the boat?" They say, "Well, it's full of water." Why? I say, "Well, I use it to store water or drink out of it or something." I say, "Well, why don't you just empty the boat out, and now it's empty, and you can go across the river?" You know, it's not useless. It can be used. Or somebody has an empty glass and they're thirsty, and you say, "Well, let me fill it up with water." And they say, No. Why? "Well, I'm using it to hold air. You know, I'm using it to hold air." I gotta use it. No. You pour some water in and drink the water. So this world, we don't have to get rid of the world, we don't have to destroy it, we don't have to do anything. We just give a different purpose for it, different use for it. And that is just to see the holy instant. Change perception, change our purpose for the world. That leads to the most we can do with the continuity problem as we are here in this world, as we imagine ourselves to be. That's the most we can do. That is the best that we can do. And I say that ultimately we will dwell in the death-free realms, and we may even be going there soon, actually, for those who understand this progression. That is very possible. Because the world is going to become obsessed with the contingency issue. It's already obsessed, but it's going to become hyper-obsessed with it. And that's a big problem for those who are not hyper-obsessed with it. Okay, we're all obsessed to some degree with the contingency issue. Except for those who have spent a lot of effort to switch and use the Holy Spirit as their guide and focus on the continuity issue. The rest are very obsessed with the contingency issue. But there are many who are not hyper-obsessed. They're saying, I don't want to get into that hyper-obsession. They say, no, that could be a big problem. And they don't want to. So there's a lot in this world who don't want to become hyper-obsessed with the contingency issue. What are they going to do? Because those who want to become hyper-obsessed are going to turn the screws on everybody else and say, hey, you've got to, either you're with us or you're against us. And if you're against us, you're trying to sabotage our salvation. And therefore, as a saboteur, you're going to be dealt with very harshly. Very harshly. Really, they'll see you as a severe saboteur. So what are you going to do? Well, you certainly, at some point, you need to relocate from this planet at some point. And where you relocate to, there are various options. The ultimate option is a death-free realm. But it's not the only option, actually. There are places that are less hyper-obsessed with the contingency plan. They're still obsessed, but not hyper-obsessed. When you go into a hyper-obsession with the contingency plan, you're really... tune out the continuity issue entirely. It's like a radio dial. You listen to the radio station, then you just turn the dial and just go into total static. Whereas a lot of people in this world have turned their dial a little bit away from the station, so it's kind of fuzzy and, you know, a lot of static, but they can still kind of hear something. With hyper-obsession with the contingency plan, moves the dial away from that station, and you just get snow, fuzz, static. That's it. Just static. Just static. It's like going from a television station. You go to a station that has nothing on it. I mean, in the past, now they have blue screen, but in the past, it would just be snow. You know, just snow. It's like that. You can get nothing out of it. They just tune it out. So there's this huge, huge cycle right now, the Kali Yuga cycle of tuning out the continuity plan entirely, tuning it out entirely. And anyone who doesn't do that will be seen as a very, very dangerous saboteur. So, just letting you know this. This is an issue. It is an issue here. The ultimate, our real issue is the contingency. I'm sorry, is the continuity. Got to keep those. It's a continuity issue. Continuity issue. And focusing on the continuity issue brings us to safety, because we will see what is useful for that. So we'll have options. We'll say, this is an option because it's very useful. See? So that's what we will do. But again, this hyper-obsession with the contingency plan is going to spring up fast, like a plant that's like a weed growing really, really fast. I mean, like it's like a tomato plant. It's already planted, and its root, the roots are deep, and then suddenly when the heat gets hot, tomato plant just grows so fast it shocks you. You know, it's one of those type of situations that the growth will be shocking. We need to be aware of this. We need to put our attention on the continuity issue. Listen to the Holy Spirit. How is that continuity issue resolved? There is a way to resolve it. And get familiar with that, and get familiar with the big picture. Just keep looking at the big picture. Don't worry about the details. Don't worry about them. That's ridiculous to worry about that stuff. It's like there's a tsunami coming on a beach, and someone tells you need to count the grains of sand on the beach before you can leave it. That's crazy. That's the ego. Get off the beach. So, this hyper-obsession is coming very, very soon. The roots are all there. The roots are all there. The root system is all there. And it's a type of situation where a plant above ground will grow super fast, boom, 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 like that. And you'll be saying, oh my gosh, what happened? So, remember, continuity issue is the only issue that can be resolved. Holy Spirit is the guide to resolving it. We can claim diplomatic immunity, diplomatic protection, and God, the grace of the Holy Spirit, subsidizes the whole situation. Those who choose to that this is their issue, to work on this issue, will be subsidized. There is a subsidy type of situation involved. Just like, you know, when they pay farmers to not grow food, they subsidize. And the government subsidizes so many things to have things work the way they want it. Well, the Holy Spirit also can subsidize. We may not understand the ways that it subsidizes, but it absolutely can. And will subsidize us. Subsidize us to not see process. There's a subsidy program for that. So you decide, okay, I don't want to see process. I'm going to see the holy instant. Then there is a subsidy grace called the grace of God, the grace of the guru. There is that that is in play also. So subsidy program, diplomatic immunity, relocation, right use of time, right use of mind. These are the words that should be percolating through through your attention, and remaining a workaholic on the spiritual path. There is no other way. Again, the other way is slim and none. So even though there's a lot of workaholics in this world, many, many people are in different ways. Some are fitnessaholics, where they get up every day, no matter how they feel, they're going to work out. Every day they work out. Every day some people go and try to make as much money as possible. Every day, you know, some people try to do their art or their music, whatever they do. And so every day you can get up and say, I'm just, no matter how I feel, I'm going to try my very best today to have the vision of the holy instant, allow the holy instant to see the freedom, vision of freedom from all process, all steps, all completion, any attempt to complete anything. I can see that today. I'm going to work really hard to see that today. I'm going to work on the continuity issue today. I'm going to listen to the Holy Spirit today. And I'm going to differentiate between what is useless and what is useful today. I'm going to do my very best to succeed at that today, and use the day, use your time in the day exactly that way. And in doing so, one day you'll say, hey, this is easy. This is easy. What's all the difficulty about? It's easy. Well, it wasn't always easy, but all those days you put in, days and nights you put in, they make it eventually seem very obvious and very easy. And that is our goal. In closing, I might have a special Super Bowl program for you this Sunday as alternative programming to the Super Bowl, okay, which is a very good idea to have alternative programming. Very good idea, because that is part of the plan of this shift into a hyper-obsession with the contingency issue, hyper-obsession. That's part of the shift. It tries, it's the biggest, like, viewing audience of anything, and it hits you with the maximum push with all the commercials and all everything that surrounds it, and the game, everything that surrounds it is designed to hook you into hyper obsession with the contingency effort of the ego, okay, which is a complete waste of time and will lead you into terrible suffering, as a matter of fact. So alternative programming to the Super Bowl, stay tuned. I'll try to put that up. If I can get to it, we'll see what my right use of time is, so that it's available for you to for your viewing, which would be 12 o'clock West Coast time, because that would be 3 o'clock East Coast time. So I'd have to have it up maybe Saturday night. I'll have to have that up. So we'll see. I'll just put a smorgasbord together of just stuff that maybe just might interest you. Maybe I'll make a whole bunch of commercials for you to look at. And I do this as service to help out. It's my pleasure to do this, because I know that the Holy Spirit is teaching truly, and the ego is a liar and deceiver, that the continuity issue can be solved, the contingency issue can never be solved, and we have every right to remember reality and have the continuity issue resolved for us, every right, and the sooner the better. So let's get it soon. All right, very great. That's it for this one.